Thank you. Hi, my name is Jill Smith. I'm a senior from Gothenburg High School.
She doesn't even go here.
And this is my poem entitled, I Can't Explain to My Mother Why the Mouthwash Bottle is Empty. This is something I swore I wouldn't write about because there's no way to put it without a 14 plus label, and I don't want to write it any other way. Sorry. The only reason I did this anyway is because my counselor told me that writing could be beneficial, and I hope it is, but for somebody else who doesn't know how to write their own story yet. I know this poem won't become a number one bestseller because nobody wants to hear the gory details about what it was like the first night I ever thought it was okay to puke up my food, because who wants to hear another sob story about a girl who tried to contact a crisis hotline when her phone died and was left in dark silence? I don't want to personify my hands and say they were shaking like a scared child whose biggest fear was right before them, because I was that scared child, and no sort of description could show what made those shaky hands and wobbling feet move off the bed and slither towards the toilet. I'm sure there's symbolism somewhere about the fact that one end of my toothbrush makes me puke and the other cleans it up, but the vomit reminds me that it's not supposed to be pretty. That's why the first four times I did it, I closed my eyes and flushed the toilet. I'm still not used to it. And when I tear myself off the bathroom floor and feel tears falling down my cheeks, I will remind myself that I'm not crying because of this depressing story. I'm crying because I'm gagging. They don't write our stories right. These stories are far too explicit for them to hit the bookshelf, so I'll use a metaphor to make it easier for everyone else. I am thrift shop trash. A book with folded edges and a broken spine. I have stains from last night's dinner on my shirt. Scratch that, stains from last night's dinner on my pages. But if you decide to lounge into bed with me in between your palms, your search for a climax will be pointless because I'm too scared to kill myself and everybody else is too scared to write it. I'm an author who doesn't like to write endings because they're too easy and nobody likes a story that you can predict. I don't want to be some quirky, relatable character because this shouldn't be. Puking up your food isn't a character trait. The only time they write decently about us is when we're the secondary character who changes the life of the main ones. Like, please stop puking. Don't you know how hard this is for me? As if dry heaving is the easiest thing that I've ever done. And after countless hours of downplaying the abuse I put myself through, I will finally be able to label this story as a fairy tale. Because 50 pounds down and enough editing to make it look like a work of fiction finally puts me as the pretty protagonist. But how do I tell someone that the eating disorder is not the antagonist? For someone who deals with this, the villain will still be me, but fatter.